Hey there, Larry Stein, Texas A&M AgriLife Extension Service with you today. Hope y'all are doing well today. Today we're talking everything pecans. You know, fall is in the air. We hope fall's in the air. It's not really cooling off that much, but anyway, the days are getting a bit shorter. Nights are getting longer. It is cooling, a bit cooler in the morning. So, you know, fall is in the air. Next week, officially, we start fall. So today we're talking pecans. Pecans are something that we think about in the fall as a delicacy that we eat in pecan pie, cookies, whatever. But really we need to think about pecans all year long. Everybody knows, at least I hope they know, that the pecan is the state tree of Texas. So the pecan is highly thought of in Texas. You know, a lot of people claimed they would never plant a pecan in their backyard, but then again, we had a governor at one time. He didn't want a monument of stone, rather he wanted a pecan tree planted at his grave so the nuts could be gathered and given to the people of Texas so Texas could become the land of trees. So pecan has been very important to the economy of Texas for a long time. The current crop this year is actually pretty good. You know, there's a deal that goes out on about pecans. You have a big crop one year, and next year you don't have a crop. And the cyclic nature of pecans has always been. The Indians were the first to note that. Way back when, the Indians would frequent a river bottom every other year. In other words, they would go to a bottom one year, they had a big crop, and they knew that next year they did not need to go back there because that bottom would be off. And so they would choose another spot to go to. So there's always an up and down in pecans. We think the better you take care of your trees, the less the up and down. So this year is a moderate to a good crop across the state. It's really looking good. We had a lot of good spring rains. So nut size is very large. And so we'll show you some of the different varieties here directly. But basically nut size is large because we had good early spring rain. The other thing is, since we have a pretty good crop across most of Texas, the insect pressure has really been kind of light. It's kind of been spread out. And so we didn't lose an entire crop to something like pecan nut case bearer. Now I want to show you something that I want to focus in on closely. Pecans are one of the crops that are on the tree that you have to take care of longer than any other fruit or nut crop. So these pecans were pollinated back in May. And so you see this little bitty nut right there, that little bitty nut right there. Here's another one right here. Those were pollinated back in May. And so pecan nut case bearer killed those particular pecans. This is the one that survived. So this started all the way back in May, middle of May, and here we are all the way middle of September. And we're not done yet. We're not done yet, and that's the gist of what we want to talk about today. You know, a lot of people think when we get to September, you can just, pack up your things, get ready to harvest. And in fact, that's what people did years ago. Our commercial growers would get ready to harvest in September, and then the crop would not finish out filling if we did not get some fall rains. So realize now is the most important time to have irrigation on pecans. So if you have pecans in your backyard, now is critical to finish out the nut fill. You have to finish out the nut fill, and then you have to have the water to make the shucks open up. So notice that we're irrigating these particular trees right here. We have the sprinkler running. The sprinkler's running at the drip line of the tree to the edge of the canopy. So that's where we're running the irrigation. And so what you want to do is you want to continue to irrigate these trees until you have shuck split on the nuts. And that way we know the nut has filled out, the kernel has filled out, and the shuck will open up. So this late season water, this is something I figured out in my research years ago, 30 plus years ago, we figured out we have to water pecans late season. And so what we're looking at is for the next, so this is the middle of September, so the next 2 weeks of September and the next 2 weeks of October, we need to be applying 2 inches of irrigation water a week. And so it doesn't matter how you put it out there. You can use a sprinkler. You can use drip irrigation. You can use a water hose. You just got to make sure you put the water at the drip line of the tree so that indeed the trees can take up the water. Now, something we want to talk about is the way these pecans fill. The way these pecans fill. So here is a nut. This is the nut. And this is the shuck. And then you see this rag right here. This is the rag. And so what happens is, when you take a pecan, the nutrients pass through the stem, they pass up the shuck, they go all the way down the shuck, and then they enter in through this rag, And so anything that disrupts the flow of nutrients in this shuck disrupts the fill of the pecan. And so that's one thing you need to remember is, the other thing is the pecans fill from the tip to the base. They don't start down here, they start up here. And so when you cut these pecans, you want to cut them at the base of limb to see how well they're filled. Now a lot of people have had a lot of pecans drop on the ground. We've had a lot of questions about that. They're thinking that they've dropped a tremendous number of pecans, but realize this is a normal process, and we actually hope for the trees to drop some pecans. Typically, the trees will drop about 40% of the crop they set. About 40% of the nuts that a tree sets drop from the tree and will be of no good. They will not be any good. And so just because you see a lot of pecans dropping from the tree, not that big a deal. Not that big a deal. Now the other thing is, the nuts fill from the outside to the inside. So here, let me get a later fill of pecan here, and let's look at it. So here is this pecan right here. Here's the pecan. This is the shuck. The brown is the shell. And then the white is the kernel. So you see how we have that little bit of air space in the middle of the kernel? So the kernel fills from the outside, from the shell to the inside. And so we still have that air space in there. And so that means that these nuts are still filling, and that means that that water we're applying right there is ultra critical to the finish of these pecans. If we stop watering, then these nuts don't fill to the exact size and percent kernel that we're looking for. So late season water, real, real important. Realize just because you have a little bit of air space in there at this point doesn't really hurt you that much. So continue to water and these will fill out. The other thing you need to know is, as long as the shell is white, you see how you have some of the shell that's brown, some of the shell that's white. As long as the shell is white, the nut continues to fill. So a lot of us have the notion, when these nuts start to split, we go out there and collect them. You know, we want to beat the varmints to it, and if you indeed have a varmint problem, then that probably is a good thing. But you notice how the shucks on these that are peeling out here are still white. That means that if we leave these on the tree, they're going to fill more than they're filled right now. So unless you have a varmint problem, we try to leave these nuts on the tree as long as possible. Now, let's talk about some of the different varieties. So right now, early season, this is middle of September, we've had shuck split on Pawnee for about 2 weeks. This is Pawnee. Pawnee, a very early ripening variety. You see how the shucks are brown. So those nuts are coming out. You see how the shell is totally brown. And so Pawnee is typically the first variety that we can harvest. And so Pawnee is getting ripe. Now we have Kansa that is getting ripe. And notice how we have good shuck split on these. And when you peel them open, indeed, the shell is all brown. The shell is all brown. So these two nuts ripen very early in the season. And actually, these two nuts make very good pollinator plants. In other words, if you plant a Pawnee and you don't have any other pecan trees around, you plant Kansa, and Kansa will pollinate Pawnee and vice versa. Now the other thing you need to realize is, we're talking about improved varieties, but check out this branch right here. Check out this branch right here. This happens to be a native pecan. This is a native pecan. And look how far advanced it is. So in nature, in Mother Nature, we have all this different genetics about when these pecans mature and open up. And so this particular native has been genetically primed to open extremely early in the season. And so that's a good thing. That's a good thing. A lot of times, though, we have these early ripening native pecans in these bottoms, and the squirrels and varmints get them before you ever know they're ripe. So we have all these different ripening periods that we have out there. Notice on this particular shoot right here now, we have the leaves have been removed. That's deer pressure. And so when you have limbs hanging down like so and the varmints eat the leaves, this is deer. And so realize that these branches where the varmints have eaten the leaves off, these nuts are not going to be any good. There's no way they can finish filling out because you don't have the leaves to finish filling them out. And so that is a problem with varmints in certain parts of Texas, and so that's something that we need to be concerned about. So we've talked about the early ripening varieties. We said Pawnee, Kansas are ripening really, really early. There's another one that ripens fairly early. This is Mandan. Mandan is another one that was released. And so this one here is ripening, and notice that the shell is pretty much brown, and so it's actually ready to go. But we have these later maturing varieties, like Desirable. This is a Desirable pecan, and it still has a ways to go. So if you cut it open, you know, it looks like it's totally filled, but it still has a ways to go, so it's not quite ready. So these later ripening varieties, you have to keep the water on. This happens to be Sioux right here, Sioux, and it's a later ripening variety as well. And if we cut one of those, you're going to see that it probably has airspace in it. Yep, still has the airspace in there. So this one here has a ways to go. So that's why we're really harping on the water deal today. We really need to keep the water on these trees. We've had good rain. September, we're having a lot of sun, and it's actually fairly warm for September. But realize that's a good thing as long as you have adequate water, because pecans can tolerate all the heat in the world, but it's the lack of water that causes us an issue. So as long as you keep the water on and the pecans stay well watered, then you're going to be in really, really good shape. Now, some of you guys want to plant a pecan from a nut. Maybe you want to plant a pecan tree, you've never planted one before, and you want to get a tree. And the easiest way for you to get a tree to come up is to take a nut directly out of the shuck. Like this nut right here was in this shuck right here. And so we're going to peel it out, and we're going to put it in a potting soil. We're going to cover it up. We're going to keep it watered, not overly wet, just moist. In about 10 days, 2 weeks, maybe 3 weeks, you're going to have a pecan tree come right out of that. And that's a big problem that we have on pecans. When we have stress late season, we have this thing called viviparity, pre-harvest germination, where when it's warm and the shucks don't open up all the way, like this particular shuck right here, it's turning black right there and not opening up. So a shuck like that, a nut like that, and a shuck like that can germinate, because you have all this moisture in there and it's warm. It's a great incubator, and so that pecan is very prone to germinating in the shuck, which is not a good thing. But if you're looking for a tree, that's the surest way that you can get one planted right now, and it will come up in a matter of days. So those of you that have some of these early ripening pecans, maybe you have a native or whatever, these are probably the best pecans that you will ever eat. The flavor of the early season pecans is just really, really outstanding. And so a lot of times what I do is I'll pick these out of the shuck once they're fully mature. I'll put them on the dashboard of my truck, and within 2 to 3 days, they're ready to eat. And the first time you'll eat one of those pecans, you'll think, wonder what. And so the other thing is, you need to realize that when when you buy pecans, if you're going to somebody to buy pecans, what you want to do is cut them at the base end. Because remember what I told you? They fill from the tip down. And so we want to make sure that the bottom of the nut is full. You know, people that are trying to sell pecans will cut them at the top because the top is sure to be full, but it's the bottom that's the key. That's the key. So a knife is critical. A lot of people will use, a shears to cut them. But if you're going to consume these things, you can use a pocket knife to cut them. And you can shell them out. This is one that I've dried. This one has been dried. And so it's actually ready to eat. It's ready to eat. And so we can go ahead and shell it out. And notice the very well-filled kernel that we have. Very well-filled kernel that we have. Now, the big thing that I want to impress upon you today is that pecans are good for you. Not only do they make pretty trees, they taste good, but eating pecans is a very good thing for you. Pecans help lower your bad cholesterol, the LDLs, and they don't interfere with the good cholesterol. And so if you have cholesterol issues, we encourage you to eat pecans. 20 halves a day. You ought to eat 20 halves a day. They also have a lot of antioxidant properties in them. And so consuming pecans is a really, really good thing for you. A lot of people have been skeptical over the years because of all the fat. But realize that's unsaturated fat. Unsaturated fat. 70% of the oil in pecans is oleic acid. Oleic acid is the same thing in olives. So you can either eat olive oil or you can eat pecans and you will be in good shape. One last issue that some people are having to deal with this year are a bit of stink bug issues. You see the black spot right there? Black spot right there. Here's another one with a black spot. Those black spots are caused by stink bugs, leaf-footed bugs, green stink bugs, brown stink bugs, and so they can be a big issue. So late season like this, when it turns off hot and dry, these stink bugs, you know, it's been green all year, so if you don't have green, these stink bugs are going to move into the tree. So if you see this type of damage on your kernels, then you'll know that you had some late season stink bugs. So I don't reckon there's any questions today. No questions today. So I thank you for joining us today as we talk about pecans. Remember, not only do they taste good, but they're good for you. So I hope you'll enjoy a bountiful harvest in your backyard. If not, pecans ought to be readily available. And remember, the money you spend for pecans, you're really getting a quality nut, very good for you. And so I would really encourage you to enjoy, pick some up and enjoy them today. So this has been Larry Stein, Texas A&M AgriLife Extension Service, talking pecans. Until next time, happy gardening and eat a pecan.